Great Debaters Contest is brought to you by Safaricom M-Pesa.
Hello and welcome to another great episode of the Great Debaters Contest. I am your host, Austin Nyambok.
And I am Mariam Bishar.
Should African countries adopt a one-child policy in order to curb population growth?
And debating this will be Sachohai versus Kahuhia. We hope they do this motion justice. We'll have it now. First debater, you have 3 minutes.
Ladies and gentlemen, Africa is facing a big problem. The rate of population growth is ravenously growing at a very high rate, such that governments are failing to curb this problem. One of the major issues is the sub-Saharan, with a rate of 2.5%. As a research carried out by the UN organization, this doubles the rate of Latin America. Take the example of Kenya itself. 2009, census carried out, we had 38.6 million population. 2011, research carried out, we had a population of 41.2 million. 2014, a research carried out, we had a population of estimatedly 45 million. Actually, the trend and the curve that has been drawn shows that in 2020, Kenya is said to have a population of 52 million. In 2050, Kenya is said to have a population of 95 million. The question that lies in our hands, will Kenya be able to sustain this? If we still face issues of unemployment, if we still face issues of poor services offered by social amenities such as hospitals and schools, what's next? Is Kenya going to manage 95 million? And so we came up with a measure that is able to curb this problem, and that's the one-child policy. To my first point, government expenditure. The gross domestic product versus government expenditure. As statistics carried out, Kenya had a budget for the country, 1.3 trillion in 2010-2011 years. Now it stands at 1.7 trillion, while the GDP stands at 44.1 million. Compare those two rates, doesn't work. And so what I propose is one-child policy should be put curb population so that the government expenditure is reduced. Kenya is being put down. We're borrowing loans and from financial institutions and other foreign aids. We're not beggars. Come on, Kenya. We can stand as our own selves, and one way we can stand this is by reducing population. Another thing is schools. Shh, silence. Demonstrations, boycotts, strikes. Why? Teachers want more funds. The ratio between teachers is 1 to 160. Is there quality education coming from there? The answer is no. As I conclude, ladies and gentlemen, let's implement this policy for the better of generations, for your child. Leaders, as we stand here, I, wanting to become the president of Kenya, this will work, the one-child policy. Thank you.
First opposer, you have 3 minutes to give your opening statements.
From Kahuhia Girls High School, I am Diana Esther Wamboi, ardent to oppose this motion that states that African countries should embrace a one-child policy to contain population growth. Now, the one-child policy was adopted in China in 1979, actually. And in recent years, starting from 2012, deliberations have been going on to end this particular policy. So China have tried it, they've tested it, and they don't trust it anymore. So why should we? Now, for the 34 to 35 years it's been going on in China, history remembers and will continue to remember the policy as an extreme example of state intervention in human reproduction in this modern era. It is an idiosyncrasy that can only be born of a government that wants to plan population like it plans the production of goods. Fellow Africans, I want to tell you that the problem is not population. The problem is its distribution. The problem is lack of development. Now, Africa is estimated to have to cover 25% of the world's land. We only house 15% of the world's population. That only means that there's a 10% that has not been occupied. So, the problem, I say again, is not overpopulation. Now, Article 32 of the Kenyan Constitution, which is an African state, states that all have freedom of conscience, religion, belief, and opinion. Now, Christians believe that the Lord in Genesis chapter 1, verse 27 to 28, saith that I put man on this earth to be fruitful and to multiply. He did not say to give a fruit. He said to be fruitful, which is plural, not singular. Not all of us here are firstborns. Imagine what we would be denying ourselves if we didn't have these amazing people with us. What would Kenya be without these people? What would Africa be without you people? Probably, actually, on the opposing side, there is no firstborn. So this motion will definitely not be going on without us. So this ban child policy is a hindrance. This room would actually be only quarter full. Only a quarter full. Because of what? A mere one child policy? Thank you.
We'll now hear cross-examinations. We begin with the second proposer.
Alicia Eldred wrote a poem about children. She said, and the title was, Dreams Within Reach. No balls, no chains to tie me down. My true colors shine through to help hide the frowns of choices made and friends left behind. To take care of two girls, I proudly call mine. Now these are two girls. What if it was one child? Would not the love, the care, and the parental responsibility be better? I want someone to really answer me this question. When the Jubilee government came into power, there's one really conspicuous promise that they gave us. Free laptops to every child in public schools. Have you actually looked at the population in those schools? Yes. There is a really overpopulation of these children, and it has now been roughly 2 years, and they cannot still keep up with their promise. As you can see, there are no free laptops. Or can someone show me which free laptop they've got if they're from public schools, or if their siblings have got any? Diana, my dear Diana, you said that when China really tested the one-child policy, that the tests came negative. Actually, it's not negative. 400 million people have not been born, have not really come to an overpopulation. This that would have come would have set out many challenges that we are now facing. We see that in Afghanistan and Pakistan, that there are children who are sold to a family, like 30 children to one parent. They misuse these children into taking them into suicidal bombs. That's why you see that in the whole of African, North African countries, we see war. We see that even in Africa, there is famine, that there is hunger, that there is poverty. Why? You all want to keep on having more children, and you know that you cannot keep up with these children, right or wrong? My dear judges, I am sure that you are all parents to one kid or two kids or three children. I am sure that there is a really big parental responsibility endowed upon you to take care of that child who will be a labor upon to the government to help. Now, the government needs labor, but even in that labor, it also has social amenities that it should also counteract with the labor that we pay in. If we are overpopulated, the quality of such amenities, such as hospitals, the schools, and even the roads and the bridges will not be enough. Children should be treated as emperors. The generations that are coming forth are going to be able to renew us from this third world country and misery that we are seeing. Being overpopulated, we have no money. But if we have enough people, we have enough children, we have enough resources, this generation will help us become a second and even maybe first. Please, think about it. One child is enough. One child is enough labor. Not many children causing poverty. Thank you.
The opposing team, you may also give your cross-examination. You have 3 minutes.
Wairimu Ushel Midwanja, from Kahuhia Girls High School. My worthy opponent, I would love to tell you that the ethnic minorities in China were not following and are not following the one-child policy. So it is a problem to them and they want to stop it. We should not adopt it. The one-child policy will hinder the maximum utilization of resources. A large population is required to maximize resources, the utilization of resources. Now, did you know that Kenya is sitting on a lot of wealth? According to the Nairobian dated July 2014, page 12, we've shown that Turkana has water that can run out of every tap in this country for the next 70 years. Turkana, again, has barrels of oil that amount to 60 billion Kenyan shillings. Now, if we adopt the one-child policy, which I hope you're not thinking of doing, we will not have maximum manpower to extract these resources, and hence, they will not be utilized. The one-child policy, ladies and gentlemen, will lead to a negative population growth. Negative population growth is whereby the number of births is less than the number of deaths. Do we really want to control our population when countries like Germany and Switzerland are struggling day and night to maximize their population because they have realized that low population is a threat to them? They are actually giving incentives for people to go out on working days and make children so that their population can increase, so that it can be a boost to their economy. Now, ladies and gentlemen, Kenya does not have time to go out and do all that when we can simply look at distribution, not the one-child policy. The one-child policy is a drawback to infrastructure. Now, did you know that even before Kenya began thinking of building Thika Superhighway, Nigeria had already had that as water under the bridge? Now, the one-child policy is no solution. Nigeria is the most populous country in Africa with a population of approximately 130 million Africans, Kenyans. No, it is not the one-child policy. If we control population growth, it will be very detrimental to our economic development. Now, China has a population of 1.357 billion. India has a population of 1.252 billion. Nigeria has a population of 130 million. They are economic powerhouses. We import a lot from them. One-child policy? Really? No. It is not the solution. If you were given a choice to either give birth to a boy or a girl, whom would you choose? Boys? Girls? It is a choice, one choice in your whole lifetime. How many would choose to give birth to a boy? Girls? That is what the one-child policy will do to us. It will limit us to one choice. The one-child policy is an enemy, and we should fight it, not adopt it. Thank you.
I'm poor, robbed and sick, but mother wills to bail me out. With cash yet far to pick, leaves me pained and strained. Oh, but son, she said, that M-Pesa is worth aid. With services like cash transfer, I can fund anyone, though far.
Take part in the M-Challenge by sending your short song, rap or poem about Safaricom M-Pesa on WhatsApp and you could win 1,000 shillings in Safaricom airtime.
Tell Paul from Utumishi with a question for the proposers. So you are supporting one child policy. Suppose this one child dies at a time when you can't have another, then how will your generation go on?
I'm Nora from the Mary Hill Girls School. You are opposing the one child policy. I did not get the solutions you gave to you going against it quite clear.
May we have the third proposer take the stage.
Meda Kongin from Sacho High School. You have to know that there is an amendment in the one-child policy. As an example, we have China. If your child dies or if your child is born disabled, you are given another chance to have another one. And if by any chance you cannot be able to have another child because it is biological or it is a biological or medical problem, You can adopt one. How many children are suffering in children's homes where they don't have food? They don't have education. They can't get proper education. You can adopt one and support one, right? So that means we have a second option. Now back to our topic. We are talking about using our resources very well. Now let me ask you a question about the Telkom Kenya company. Why are people being retrenched? Why are people being retrenched? The population is bursting. We don't have enough resources over there to support the number of people working there. We don't have enough money to pay the people. And you're telling me here to allow parents to have more children. So you want those children out there to continue suffering. You want those children out there to continue going to mediocre schools. You want those children out there to continue sleeping on an empty stomach. Is that what you're trying to tell us? Remember, Nigeria has their population exploding. That is why you find that most of the people are idlers. For example, the kidnapping of the girls. What if those people were employed? They would have done something better. They would have done something better for their country. That's right. So idlers are because of having a lot of population in Africa. They have nothing to do. They have nowhere to go. They'll end up continuing stealing from you in those streets out there. Why do you walk with your phone deep in your pocket? Because there's somebody idling there. It's not their fault. It's not their fault at all. Thank you.
Third opposer, you have 3 minutes to respond.
The sweetness of the pudding is in the tasting. A one-child policy, alien, foreign, and new. It has never been tasted by any African country. Now our question is, how sweet is it? Naima Nditi from Kahuhia Girls High School, urgently opposing the motion, African countries should embrace a one-child policy to contain population growth. I'll start by answering the questions. The question on sex preference, yes, sex preference brings about an imbalance in the population. Now let's ask ourselves one question. What if God gave each and every one of us a boy and we have only one chance to get a child? I believe the one who answered this question will not get a wife to marry when time comes due to imbalance in the sex preference. Again, the solutions other than one child policy, distribution, development, good leadership. Development again, and resources to cater for this population is the best contraceptive, if any. Now, sometimes between 106 and 43 BC, a great Roman statesman and orator, Marcus Cicero, once said, "The wise are instructed by reason, ordinary minds by necessity, the stupid by experience, brutes by instinct." That was 2,000 years ago. Yet listening to arguments made on population, it cannot help us feel and think that Cicero was talking about these modern times, because it is in modern times that arguments are made without the benefit of reason. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you today a voice of reason. Large population provides labor, which is a human resource. Now, with a good purchasing power, it becomes a good market base. Let us look at China. They are their own producers and their own consumers. India and Malaysia. Malaysia are actually known as the paper tigers of this world. Why? Because they produce paper and consume paper. No surplus, no wastage. Again, necessity is the mother of invention, they did say. Large population gives us a platform for technological inventions and creativity. If we go down south to Kalahari Desert, the Khoi Khoi and the San are unable to modernize their ways of living. Why? The population is limiting them. Cairo, on the other hand, are great in producing rice in Africa. We import rice from Cairo. Why? The large population has enabled them to devise ways to curb problems such as food shortage and hunger. From our motion, for something to be contained, then it has to be a problem. Well, I agree and I second the fact that there is a problem to solve. Africans, there is a problem to solve. But the problem is not population. The problem is its distribution. The problem is not population. No, no. The problem is the spacing of births between children. The problem is not population. The problem is development, leadership, resources to cater for this population. Cicero said, "Appetitas rationi parit." Let your desires be ruled by reason. One child policy is not the solution. Thank you.
We'll now hear closing arguments, beginning with the proposers. You have 1 minute.
A large population or a bursting population has a negative impact to all of us. We can all feel it even here in Kenya. We can all feel it. We watch it on TV daily. And it hurts me and pains me a lot that we still cling to the analog ways. Because right now, we are mechanizing technology in our country, meaning we need less labor. We need less people, but more work is done, right? More machines, less people. That means the population continues bursting, we continue making our children suffer. The population continues bursting, we continue straining our government. The population continues bursting, we continue to rely on funds from outside. And we continue suffering as Kenyans. Why ain't we independent? We are too many for the government to handle us. Why are other African countries not independent? We are depending on other people. So let's think about it, Kenyans. Should our children continue suffering, or should we embrace the one-child policy and ensure in future we have everything quality? Quality input, quality output. Sacho High School, we have spoken. Thank you.
Opposers, your closing statement. You have 1 minute.
Now, I've come to recognize the fact that family planning is a difficult task. So what happens if you get yet another child? Do you kill it? Do you let it live? Now, I've said it before and I'll say it again, that Africa's problem is not population, but development. Africa has vast territories, from Benin to Cameroon, to Cote d'Ivoire, to Gabon, to Chad, to Togo, to Central Africa, which are 6 times the size of France. These countries house 77 million people, while France houses 63 million people. So if anyone needs a one-child policy, then it's definitely France and not us. As Julius Nyerere once said, that if a country has land and it has people, it is certain that it will definitely develop. And today I stand here to second him and agree with him. Africans, fellow Africans, we need all the brains, we need all the hands, we need all the resources we can amass to take this continent to the very next level. Thank you.
To Sacho High School, to Jabez, you're a strong, fast speaker and you compose your team very well when you start up. However, when the bell goes, you need to check on your time so that you're not penalized. Cynthia as well, great speaker. However, check your facts, because you said the Kenya police civilian ratio is 1 to 6,000. I think your facts are not right.
Kahuhia, I think a strong team, beginning with Diana, extremely good submission. And when you're looking at the leaders, possibly what I expected is you could look at which leader is which born. And possibly say, this is a prominent leader, he did this, he was this born. And therefore, if we were looking at one child policy, then this leader could not have been born. Possibly it could have made your team stronger. But nonetheless, it was good submission.
Sacho High, your examples were not diversified. You seemed to have focused a lot on one country, and yet you were thinking about the African continent. Kahuhia girls, great job. Done. And so all I can say is all the best to the two teams.
It's down to the judges to give us the results. And they give Sacho High School 67.2%. Let's give them a hand. And to Kahuhia Girls, they awarded 73.9%, making them our winners.
And from us at the Great Debaters Contest, I am your host, Austin Nyambok.
And I am Mariam Bishar. We'll see you next time.
Great Debaters Contest was brought to you by Safaricom M-Pesa.